It's something new. It's a little bit strange, but it's not negative. It's always positive. This is where life begins. This is the beginning of life. The inspiration, that's always a very difficult question. I'm not going to the art, but the art is coming to me. These eggs are falling from the sky, but the ideas are always falling in my head. When I was 3 years old, then I began to speak. And one of the first things I said, I want to make drawings. A lot of children, the first thing they do, they go out and they play outside. But I was sitting on the table and drawings. Always, 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 always. When you come from school or from your work or from whatever, then it's very fine to live in another world. That's why we have art, and that's why we have films, that's why we have everything. It's art. Yes, but I like also that everybody can enjoy what I do. This kind of art, this axe here, people are playing with it. And that's also, people think, what is this? But everyone likes it. I'm always observing what happens in all my projects, and that's very nice. You have seen also, children always play, never ask things. They accept everything, and they is all. They see it and they play with it. We have to be careful, because now we have a lot of global warming. We are destroying lives at this moment. When it's too hot, all life we will destroy. We do it ourselves. And I make this eggs. So the streets are now so hot, you can fry an egg on it. Be careful.
Eggs represent energy. 它是能量这件事情是我觉得对我来说很重要的一件事情。鸡蛋代表一天的开始，然后它当然也代表了非常多的象征性意义、新的生命、全新的开始和无限的可能。所以对我来说，它是一个非常富有象征性意义的一个元素。尤其是听到邀约我们是来澳门做这个项目，我们就更兴奋，因为我们很喜欢澳门这个地方。 我认为它是一个非常完美的结合了传统和现代，然后中西方文化的这么一个地方。之后呢，我们有想过我们要以什么样的形式来呈现它。我们定的 house 这个房子这件事情，我觉得也很重要，就是因为我们希望它不是一个博物馆，它是观众最熟悉的，像是一个他梦境中会出现的这样的一个家的样子。所以整个的这个 场景全部都是以一个家常有的会有不同的房间而呈现的。整个的房间呢是以这种五颜六色的鸡蛋树和镜面墙来去做了一个好像是你进入到这个《爱丽丝梦游奇境记》里头那个兔子洞的那个部分，就是它一下就可以把你拽进，你马上就要面对的是一个 Wonderland 这样的一个地方。我们的那面墙壁它是由真实的蛋壳去做的，然后 配上这个 baby blue 这个颜色，其实它也是跟这个房间整个的是概念是契合在一起的。然后之后呢，我们就到了客厅。客厅呢，我很喜欢那个非常小的鸡蛋的桌椅，很像小时候，然后全家人聚在一起听故事的这样的一个场景。 然后之后呢是卧室，那卧室呢就更有意思了，它就更像是你进入到了一个梦幻一样的地方，它是一个立体的床，所以呢，当你走上去以后，你站着，但其实啊，你一闭眼睛就可以像拍到一张就是像躺在床上一样的照片。然后呢，再之后呢，我们有一个非常可爱的卫生间，然后有一个非常大的蛋形的马桶，然后以及可以互交互的可以去撑的这样的一个卷纸。 我们最后的场景呢，是一个 blender，就是这个打蛋器的这样的一个走廊。蛋跟很多东西都是可以融合的，很多我们日常中想到的、想不到的、太熟悉不过的东西，其实都有蛋的存在，以及和它配合的可能。我认为这样的一个场景 是真的是无论不分背景不分年龄都一定会享受，一定会觉得有意思的。而且每个人可能都因为他的年龄不同，他的文化不同，都可能对场景会有不一样的一些想法，